A data analyst certification is one of the fastest ways to get a job as a data analyst, especially as a beginner without any work experience. When you don't have any experience, companies look at you and think, oh, do we really want to hire this guy? Does he even know anything? And that is when they see your certification and go, ah, well, he's actually certified, so let's hire him. Okay, it's obviously not that easy. But now with a massive amount of beginners and new people looking to break into data, this can actually help you stand out and be the thing that helps you get an interview and hopefully land a job. So, what's a certification? Well, you study, you take a test, and then you receive a certificate. A real credential. It's not one of those online courses that you take and get a certificate of completion, although they can be really useful as well for other reasons, especially for learning and staying motivated, and I have other videos on that. Now, in this video, I'll cover both the best beginner certifications to get your first data job and also some certifications to level up your career. So, whether you're looking for promotion or you're a beginner with no experience in data, looking to get your first job, this is going to be a game changer for you. Let's get started. Now be aware that these are not going to be in any particular order. They're all awesome in their own way, but I will include some of the more advanced certifications in the end. The first certification is by Microsoft and it's called Azure Data Fundamentals, also known as Microsoft DP900. It's a certification for beginners, although you do need a general understanding of data and how to deal with it. Databases, relational and non-relational data, and so on. If you have this knowledge, it should only take a few hours to prepare for the exam, which is literally nothing. For others, it might take a little bit longer, just a few weeks, but it's still a very quick certification. You don't have to spend months studying for this test or something. Now, the exam itself takes around an hour to do, but we'll talk more about exams later. Let's discuss how it can help you and why you should actually take this certification. So the learning before the exam is going to help you become familiar with cloud-based data services like Azure, AWS, and so on, and also get this knowledge certified by Microsoft. As you probably know, cloud is getting more and more important because, well, organizations, they use it. Now, this certification is also really good because Microsoft's tools are very popular. Microsoft Azure is very popular, and it's the same suite as Power BI, and it's a solid company, and their certifications are well known and respected. Now, I do want to say that for a data analyst, this is not going to be the most essential certification when you get started. I would recommend focusing on learning SQL and visualization software and so on first. So don't just rely on this one, because it's a little bit too specialized for a beginner. Now, it can definitely help, especially if you want to focus more on the cloud skills, but keep in mind that for getting your first job, you'll still need all of the SQL, the Dataviz, and so on. I do think the certification is a very good idea if you're planning to, you know, move into more specialized roles like data engineering later. It's going to give you a gentle introduction to some of the skills often desired over there, and so it can therefore help you prepare for different Microsoft DA or DBA certs if you want to, but as a beginner, I wouldn't even worry about this. So in case you want to prepare for this exam, how do you do it? Well, you can take their learning path on the Microsoft website. You can also go on Coursera, and there'll be a great course which is going to prepare you directly for this certification. Funny enough, it's called Preparing for DP900, and I'm going to leave a link in the description. Now, as a last option, you can also enjoy some great free resources on YouTube or anywhere else online. There are a lot of good free resources out there for learning these skills. There is not going to be an issue. Everything is out there for free online. Let's talk about the price of the certification. Now, the actual price is going to be $99 for the exam fee in the US, but the price is going to depend on your country. So in some countries, it's going to be way less, although this certification is always going to come with a fee. The good thing is that most Microsoft certifications expire within a few years. Unfortunately, this one never expires because it's part of the Microsoft Fundamentals. So that's a huge plus. It's a permanent certification. You never need to renew it. All right, let's go ahead with the next one. This is a very popular certification that I highly recommend, and it's called Tableau Certified Data Analyst. It's for beginners who are looking to become, well, data analysts, and there are no prerequisites at all for this one. You don't need years of experience or anything. It's actually for real beginners. Okay, now honestly, they do recommend 6 months of experience with Tableau itself, but this is not some kind of job experience that they demand. It just means that you should have been learning and using Tableau for a couple of months. I think it's a pretty bad idea to, you know, try to get this exam after a week, so just don't try to get the cert after like weeks of learning. I think it would be pretty useless to try to get this cert after a few weeks of learning. You know, that's going to be very difficult, so at least give it some time, but it is for beginners. So how can this certification actually help you? Well, Tableau is highly in demand, and it is a very good certification to have for jobs, as this skill is desired by many, many companies. Having this certification by Tableau, it also shows that you understand the fundamentals of data analysis in itself, in addition to, you know, being proficient in the actual tool itself. The skills you're going to be tested on and what you're going to learn when you study for this certification, I'm going to give you a quick breakdown of the core skills. First, you'll have to connect data to a data source, and then you'll have to perform some data transformations. Next, you'll have to explore and analyze this data, create some visualizations, and share the content that you create. Those are the main objectives of this Tableau certification. Now, at this point, you're probably wondering, what about the exam itself? And it's 120 minutes and completely in English. I don't think it's available in other languages. I did see it available in Japanese, but I haven't seen any other languages, so you might want to check that out if it's better for you. Now, you will get your results within 48 hours, which is going to be insanely fast, and it contains both normal questions like, you know, multiple choice, you have a couple of different options to pick between, but also a few practical assignments. And I think for most people, those are going to be the more challenging ones, so that's why it's important to prepare correctly. So, how do you prepare for this certification? Well, Tableau has a lot of different courses and different learning paths on their website, but this is unfortunately going to come at a cost. So the best way is to just start to build projects with Tableau, and you actually use it. Leverage online courses and different tutorials, for example, on YouTube. I know a lot of great people on YouTube that made some really good Tableau courses. And all of these resources are out there completely for free, just waiting for you, and you're going to learn a ton if you actually make use of them. Now, finally, the price is going to be around $250 for the entire certification, and it's just a one-time fee, so there are no other fees. Especially if you learn for free and you don't take their learning path, the entire cost of this certification is going to be the one-time fee. Now, if you do take one of their paid courses or whatever, it's going to be a little bit higher, but again, you don't necessarily have to take one of the paid learning paths. You can learn for free online. All right, let's move over to the next certification, Cloudera Certified Data Analyst. To explain who it's for, I'm just going to quote their own website. The CCA Data Analyst exam was created to identify talented SQL developers looking to stand out and be recognized by employers looking for these skills. This is a certification for SQL developers, data analysts, BI specialists, DBAs, and so on. Now, the question here is, can you take this one without any work experience? And from what I've seen, yes, but with a twist. I think that a beginner could get this certificate, but it's not going to be easy at all. You can check under the required skills here, and these things aren't impossible to learn by yourself. For example, through courses and projects. Some of these skills include creating reports, writing queries, and so on. But as mentioned, it is going to be really tough, and if you do get a certificate though, it could be a career booster. Especially as many of these skills are very important to companies, and here you're directly getting tested and certified by Cloudera. Now, what about the exam itself? Well, it consists of 8 to 12 different tasks and problems that you have to solve on your own. For all of this, you're going to have 120 minutes to take the exam, and you do need a score of 70% or above to pass, so that's pretty good. It's not too high, but also not too low. I believe that in university, perhaps that's like a C level or something. And this is about implementing a technical solution while meeting the requirements, live under time pressure, and while you're being watched by a proctor. So you will have to prepare a lot for this one. There's going to be some pressure on you, some stress, some time pressure, but also just being watched and actually having to do everything yourself live. So it's not supposed to be easy. This certification is only available in English, and the price is around $295 for the exam. They have their own course. Now, I think it requires some extensive preparation. You need to learn the concepts in and out and the specific tools. So in my opinion, although they kind of frame themselves as a beginner certification, I wouldn't really say that it's for beginners. You could do this for sure, especially if you have some experience, but for a beginner, the next one is going to be so much better. So let's move on to the next certification. This is one of my favorite certifications overall, and especially for beginners. So let's get right into it. It's called Microsoft Power BI Data Analyst Associate, or as you may know it, Microsoft PL300. This one is for complete beginners aiming to secure their first job as a data analyst and specialize and gain a lot of skills in Power BI. By preparing for the certification, you're going to learn and be tested on a few different key things. First, we have actually preparing data. Then we have modeling data, visualizing and analyzing data, deploying and maintaining assets, and of course you're gonna do everything in Power BI. Power BI is a database tool and it's highly in demand on the job market, and it's also by Microsoft, so you know that kind of makes sense. It's their own program. So we know that the cert is amazing, but how do you actually prepare for it as a beginner? Well, there are three main ways to prepare for this exam, and I'll tell you my own preference as well. The first way is to go through Microsoft's own learning path. They have a couple of different modules about this on their websites, and you can take this completely for free. I think it's a great option if you want to. But in my opinion, something that's even better is to take the Microsoft Power BI Data Analyst program on Coursera. The program is going to help you prepare for this certification directly as well. And I just like Coursera a lot. I prefer Coursera over the Microsoft, you know, the Microsoft learning path. The experience in general has been a lot better on Coursera, but it's going to be up to you, of course. The last course of this Coursera program is just about exam preparation for the PL300 exam. So it's a great program to leverage. I'm going to leave all the links in the description, and I do get a small commission if you use my link, which helps me make more videos like this. Now, there is also DataCamp and the Data Analyst in Power BI Career Track. This is also going to prepare you nicely for the exam. And as you can see, there are multiple ways. About the price of the actual exam itself, it is going to vary depending on your country and your location. For the US, as a standard price, it's going to be around $165 for the exam. On a positive note, it is a one-time fee, and you can renew it for free. And I also think the price is going to be slightly lower in other countries. If you do want to save money though, I mean, don't we all, and get a 50% discount on the certification itself, you can complete the Coursera program, as I recommended. At the end of this program, you'll get a voucher for a 50% off the certification. And this preparation program is pretty quick, so you can actually save money by doing this. The same applies for DataCamp students. They also get a 50% off, so it's up to you to pick whatever platform you prefer. I would personally go with Coursera over DataCamp because it's designed by Microsoft themselves, but of course I am biased and all of these are really good options. I actually have a full video on how to prepare for this exam, but watch that later because I still have a few great certifications to show you, possibly even better for you. As always, there are also resources on YouTube and online if you want to prepare for free. Anyway, this is definitely one of the best certifications out there for aspiring data analysts because it's for beginners, it's by Microsoft, and it's respected. One downside is that if you're a strict Tableau user, it's probably not going to be the best experience. I mean, everything's about Power BI in this one. Next up, we have the CompTIA Data Plus. And according to their own website, it is an early career data analytics certification for professionals tasked with developing and promoting data-driven business decision making. All right, that's a lot of words. Let's try to simplify this. Basically, it's an early career data analytics certificate, and you can use this one to land a few different jobs. Obviously, some easier than others, depending on your previous experience or education, or lack of both of them. I'm all about giving you the truth, and that's going to play a major part in everything, of course. If you have a master's in, I don't know, data science, of course, that's going to help you get a job. But on this channel, I want to show you how to reach your goals, regardless of your previous experience or your education, and whether you have any of that or not. Some of the jobs you can land after this certification are data architect, data analyst, data scientist, business analyst, reporting analyst, operating analyst, analyst. No, okay, enough. So how can this one actually help you get a job? Well, from my research, it seems to be one of the most well-known certifications overall, which will definitely look good on your resume. The key skills you'll learn are data concepts and environments, data mining, data analysis and visualization, data governance, quality, and controls. Now, the exam itself is around 90 minutes, and the price is quite a downside. It is a pretty expensive certification, unfortunately. The actual exam itself is around $246, and I'm not sure if this price depends on your country. I hope so, but perhaps it doesn't. That's not too bad, but to get their study guide, it's about $359 in total. Now, there should be some other resources available online for free as well, so if you want to save money, there are different options. But for the ideal preparation and exam to get the certification, you will have to spend a couple of $100. A good thing is that you only take the certification and the exam once, and then you can renew it for life for free. All right, so we covered a lot in this video. Now let's get into the more advanced certifications. And there are a lot of them, so I might make a separate video and just kind of rank the different certifications. Let me know if you want that. But even if you're just a beginner right now and you don't feel like you need these advanced certifications now, understanding these will will be very helpful. It's going to show you what skills to focus on and what's going to carry you forward to a more senior position. And it's just because I suppose you don't want to be a beginner forever. You want the higher salaries, the better jobs, and these certs will help you get there. So the first one is AWS Certified Data Analytics. This is primarily a cert to show your excellence in the cloud and dealing with AWS. It's generally speaking for people with 5 years of experience with common data analytics technologies, and you should also have 2 years of experience working with AWS. It's a 180-minute exam, so slightly longer than the other exams. This cert is on a specialty level, and to give you a brief understanding of the different levels of Amazon certifications, we have the basic foundational level first, then we have the associate level, and finally the more advanced, the higher levels, which are the professional and specialty levels. So it's made to be difficult, it's supposed to be, it's not a beginner certification. So how do you prepare for this exam, now that it's so advanced? Amazon, they're actually really nice. They have a lot of great resources to prepare for this exam, completely for free. They have an exam guide, sample questions, and so on. Everything's free, really. Now, they even have a platform for you to practice on, as well as a training, like an actual classroom training, if you prefer that. Now, don't get me wrong, this is all going to be really helpful, but I guarantee you that it's not enough to actually get this certification. The biggest preparation and something that's expected from you will be experience, hands-on work experience. These exam guidelines and practice questions, they're not meant to replace that, but rather strengthen your knowledge about specific things and fill in any gaps before taking the final test. Anyway, it's going to cost you about $300 to take the exam, and it's a one-time fee. Now, let's move on to number 6, the Microsoft Azure Enterprise Data Analyst Associate Certification. That's a really long name. I'm going to start by discussing who it's for, because it's a pretty advanced cert. According to Microsoft, you should have advanced Power BI skills, including managing data repositories, data processing, and you should also be familiar with Power Query and data analysis expressions. They also ask that you're proficient in Azure Synapse Analytics, confident working with relational databases, TSQL, and Databiz. As you can see, it is a lot, and it's not for beginners. I would say that it's more like a tool for a data professional to climb the career ladder upwards, and getting this one as a data analyst, for example, could allow you to get better job offers with higher salaries later. The price is around $165 in the US, which I think is really fair for an advanced level certification, and you prepare for it using their learning path or self-study these things, or just, you know, learn them at your job and fill in the gaps. I'm gonna leave all the links in the description, and check out this video next, handpicked by the YouTube algorithm for you. I hope this was helpful. Have an amazing week, guys.